station featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world. You've just been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience. It is necessary to be fully observant of the surrounding world. Practice by looking up, down, left, and right. Besides operating trains, there are lots of requirements to navigate on foot. Try moving around now. This is one of many interactives to be discovered, but not all of them will be as easy to find as this one. Climb aboard and take a seat in the cab with the engineers for a short ride. You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now, and then return to the game when ready. A lot of time will be spent operating trains, so when ready, sit in the engineer's seat. A heads-up display has appeared on the right side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed. The red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed. This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power control is in. These are brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems allowing independent management of them. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. This train is ready to go. Pull the indicated handle all the way back to get moving. Sandpatch Grade offers the ability to operate powerful and heavy freight trains on one of America's most stunning and famous railroads. You are currently riding an AC4400CW locomotive. These are the workhorses of trains operating over the Sandpatch Grade, with CSX Transportation having more than 600 in its roster. Train Sim World allows you to ride and drive trains from a selection of internal and external camera angles. You can change between internal and external camera views by pressing the right stick. You've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Pennsylvania. Crossing the Allegheny Mountains, the Sandpatch Grade is a vital link in the sprawling CSX rail system. Master the controls of powerful American freight locomotives operating out of the vast Cumberland Yard facility. Whether the sun is shining, there's a rain shower, or a full-on snow blizzard, it's up to you to keep the rail traffic moving. Battle your way over one of the steepest railroad grades on the East Coast. Along the way, don't forget to place safety posters, collect lost hard hats, put up no trespassing signage, and fix broken snow markers. Welcome to the Sandpatch Grade.
This is the latest generation General Purpose Type 38 locomotive built by the Electromotive Division of General Motors. Known as a GP38-2, it packs an efficient 16-cylinder diesel-electric motor able to generate 2,000 horsepower. First off, walk over to the locomotive as indicated. Open the cab door and proceed inside. To take control, you'll... Safety always comes first on the railroad. So to start with, we need to let those around us know this locomotive is operational. Begin by turning the forward headlights control to bright. There are three key controls to operating this locomotive: the reverser, brakes, and throttle. The reverser determines... To the left is the auto brake, which applies brakes along the entire... We're about to move, so make two blasts of the horn to alert anyone around. Now add some power, but not too much. Too much power too soon can damage both the locomotive . You're moving! Great work. To maintain a constant speed, move the throttle back to its idle position. That concludes the basic engineer training on this locomotive. That was great work. You've just completed your first lesson operating the GP38-2. There's always more that can be discovered, though. As engineers, we'll never stop honing our skills. Climb aboard this locomotive and we'll get started. Set the locomotive up and pull. Gently bump into the cars up ahead. The couplers will engage automatically. That's it. You got this. Now, haul them back beyond the switch in the track. For these cars with the others on the adjacent track, a switch in the track must be changed. Climb down from the locomotive and walk to the switch. Excellent. We're all set. Climb back aboard and push the cars down the track, connecting them with the others already there. Thank you. You're doing great. Keep it up. Now, to uncouple the locomotive from the cars, climb down and walk to the first freight car. Pull the cut lever to disconnect the locomotive from the cars.
Welcome to Train Sim World 2. An immersive and highly detailed rail simulation featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world. You've just been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience. It is necessary to be fully observant of the surrounding world. Practice. Besides operating trains, there are lots of requirements to navigate on foot. Try moving around now. This is one of many interactives to be discovered, but not all of them will be as easy to find as this one. You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now, then return to the game when ready. A lot of time will be spent operating trains, so when ready, sit in the driver's seat. A heads-up display has appeared on the right side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed. The red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed. This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power control is in. These are brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems, allowing independent management of them. In the top right, there are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. This train is ready to go. Push the indicated handle all the way forwards to get moving. The line from here runs to the border with Holland and Belgium and forms part of the international network of services that operate across Europe. This particular train is a third-generation intercity express built by Siemens in Germany for international operations. It is formed of 8 cars and has a top speed of 320 km per hour. Train Sim World allows you to ride and drive from a selection of camera views. Let's take a look now while exploring this train. You can change between internal and external camera views by pressing the right stick. You've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to West Germany. Prepare yourself for a high-speed ride on the world's first international railway line, linking Köln with Holland and Belgium. Experience the thrill of driving the highly modern ICE 3M electric high-speed train up to 250 km per hour, or take in the sights of the border region while riding the versatile BR442 Talent 2 articulated multiple unit. International Express or Tranquil Commuter Service, you set the pace. Along the way, don't forget to place route maps, apply safety signage, place hazard cones, and restock first aid points. Welcome to the Köln-Aachen high-speed line. Welcome to driver training here at Achen Depot. Here you will be taken through the operation of a BR442 Talent 2 electric multiple unit. During this brief introduction, we will go through the train preparation, critical driving controls and passenger operations. When you are ready, climb aboard to get started. In normal operation, this unit draws electricity from the overhead catenary via a pantograph. However, since the pantograph is currently in the down position, we have to power the initial systems by priming the auxiliary battery. Take a seat in the driver's position. This is with power available, use the master switch to unlock the control desk and turn on the reverser determines the direction of travel. Now activate the pantograph so that it raises up and set the exterior lights for normal operation. Set the indirect brake to release. This brake is finally disengage the parking brake. Thank you. coasting is a method used to efficiently maintain speed and reduce motor stress and maintenance requirements. Apply a small amount of brake force to achieve a comfortable and safe stop. Take a quick glance of the platform to ensure all is safe before unlocking the doors. It's time to get going. Set the doors to locked. Proceed to the next stop at Achen Rote Erde, unguided this time, and see how you get on.